Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and all in between and outside of our spectrum, wow. Wow, wow, wow. My brain has been blown wide open. That was one of the most
mind-blowing and spectacular finales ever.
And
and game-changing in the history of Doctor Who.
Yeah, it's incredible. Like,
I don't know what to think about it. It a lot happened.
You're bewildered, aren't you?
A lot happened. So,
whoa.
I think I know that I liked it.
Yeah, it was amazing. For me, one of the best season finales I've seen. You know what? Because I did not know what to expect.
I mean, it was better than
it kept surprising me.
I mean, it was better than the Battle of Ranskor, of course.
That was the one from the last season.
I think it was a lot better than that.
Would you prefer this one to that one?
I don't know if this is my favourite series finale.
This is one of mine, because what I think is because if we're counting all the, spoilers from the start. Already the elements you've got on this episode, you have the Master, you have Cybermen, and you have Gallifrey. Like, this just calls so much back to old Who. Like, as some of the elements that the Five Doctors had,
yes.
You know, with the Cybermen on Gallifrey and all that.
Rastorn robots and the Master.
Yeah.
And the whole Time Lords wanting to be immortal.
About Time Lords being immortal, which is interesting. So, obviously, the episode starts, and we don't see much of Brendan in this episode. Look, last week, me and Josh were thinking, what's going on with Brendan?
Yeah.
There is obviously, this episode is very much in the now, like it shows, you know, some of the fam escaping from the Cybermen. Yeah. What do we think of? Oh yeah! Before we go on to the other Cybermen, what do we think of the Cyber Warriors? They're really
probably the best. I don't know. Maybe.
Invasion-esque.
I think they're great. Yeah.
Very much in the style of the old Cybermen, going back to Tomb and
an invasion.
Maybe Revenge and Earthshock.
Oh yeah, definitely got. You know what? All of the aesthetics of being on that ship were screamed out Earthshock to me. You know, they're marching like, yeah. Bing, bing, you know, bring yeah. The sound effects and all that stuff. We've got some more of Koshamas, which is amazing. Again, Sacha Dhawan is one of the best, most surprising things about this series for me.
Oh yeah.
Because
he's such a game changer. The way he just comes on stage, onto the screen,
yeah.
Basically, and just radiates that maniacal, twisted.
He's a little bit more
insane.
He's crazier than John Sim, I think.
I think he's a little bit more crazy than John Sim.
I think it's brilliant.
Batshit insane.
Oh, it's fantastic. And he's fantastic. Oh, I love him so much. You know what? And you know what as well? Because he was so good in Iron Fist, and this, I feel like it was even better. Like, he's amazing. Like, honestly.
Who's he in Iron Fist?
He played Davos.
Davos, yeah. The Steel Serpent.
Oh, is that his comic book name?
It's his comic book name.
I
don't think he becomes the Steel Serpent.
I guess he's own. Watch it. It's good series.
Superhero,
super villain,
by the way, for you.
He's in first series. He's like an ally. Second series becomes a bit more of a villain.
Yeah.
Yeah. Definitely check it out. But anyway, back to Who. And obviously, also, guys. I think 10 out of 10 for the visuals of the destroyed Gallifrey.
Yeah, yeah.
Because when there was this room where the Doctor and the Master was in, where like the Matrix was, and the Doctor mentioned she'd fought the Matrix before. When have we seen the Matrix before in Doctor Who?
Well, originally...
The Deadly Assassin.
Deadly Assassin. Mm-hmm. And then the next time when she fights against it is in... Well, there's references to it in the books. Mm-hmm. Like in Matrix, in the Seventh Doctor's story, you see him fight the Valyard as Jack the Ripper in Victorian London. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But then before that, you see him fight against the Matrix in Colin Baker's era during his encounter with the Valyard in The Ultimate Foe.
Cool,
so
right?
There is references to that. Mm. It's basically, as we know from the episode itself, there's a whole reference to Time Lord knowledge and it's the innermost thoughts and workings of the Time Lords, psychological as well as physical.
And we learned so much more about the Time Lords in this episode. I think we learned more about the Time Lords in this episode, mm-hmm. about their origins. What was her name? The Gallifreyan Explorer.
Tectium?
So basically, obviously, the Master's like, obviously, Doctor, you know, come to Gallifrey, and they go to the Matrix and obviously
visions of her past.
Exactly.
How she treated the foundling that she found.
Yeah. So the woman who was at the
look at this. I can't find it.
2 seconds. He's getting up.
Keep talking.
While he's looking for that, we'll talk about something else. So the when they were in the Matrix.
Wikipedia, are you updating?
go on to the end credits from
the. Alright, fine. So
what I thought was really interesting. So when in the Matrix. Well, I forgot what I was going to say.
We're in the Matrix.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, and I thought the dialogue was incredible, and. Obviously, we got her in there and, started talking to her. Oh, yeah, so, and we, talked a lot about what Gallifreyans.
Tectium.
It even described what the Gallifreyans used to be called, wasn't it? They were called, I can't remember.
I can't remember.
But, it was amazing. We learned so much about Gallifrey in this episode. More than any other episode, I think. We learned more about the origins of Gallifrey society.
We also know a little bit more about the Doctor.
I think what's amazing about it, again, so, it was about this explorer, went to, different planets, found like an opening in space and time, and they found a child there, a timeless child. And as the story goes along, we realise that, this child could regenerate. And almost this child was the first regenerating
Gallifrey.
And so as we went along, then obviously, it was a little girl, regenerated again, and
this boy pushed her off.
Yeah, that's right. What I really liked about this is they had a very diverse cast of young child actors, of different genders and races, which I really really liked as well.
Yeah. Diversity.
Which I really liked as well, which is really good because heaven knows in so many programs we need more of that. And Doctor Who's always been really good at that.
Especially
it's fantastic. And that's why I think Doctor Who's at the forefront. See, Doctor Who always represents the time, and what's good about Doctor Who is it shows to all its young fans that there are people like them in this beautiful universe, and they can do just such incredible things. And there are people out there who the Doctor. Basically, this episode there was a very nice warming moment for this episode, which I thought. Because as we go along, we find out that the Doctor is the timeless child. I thought it might be the Doctor or the Master, but what I loved about it was I liked. But I thought this episode had very sort of sweet underlying messages that, to send to everybody at some point, the Doctor looked like you, which I thought is quite a sweet.
Sweet moment.
Yeah, because now it's just to everybody. Right. There was a young black actress, a young Asian actress, a young black actor, and I think there was a Middle Eastern actor as well. And literally, the day said at some point, the Doctor looked like you, and I really liked that because I feel like, because this is we all want to see ourselves in the hero, and now lots of young people can, and I think that is incredible. And shout out to Christian Bale for that, because I think this episode was amazing. Anyway, so obviously that's happening in the Matrix. The Doctor's learned that she's the timeless child, and she might have had lives she didn't know about. And in the Matrix, we get to see Ruth Doctor again. Which we don't know if she's actually there or for part of her mind, whatever.
Mindset or like a vision or something like that.
And what's incredible is that and obviously whilst all was happening, the humans are trying to escape from the Cybermen and all that, and they go to Gallifrey as well. The Lone Cyberman, The Lone Cyberman is one of the best things about this series, I think. He is honestly one of the best. I think the design, the fact that it's an amalgamation of different cybernetic designs, and the fact that it was almost human, and it was just, it was so incredible. Anyway,
But the word of Master, though, just done him, though, shrunk him.
When the Master was talking, he was like, he's going to kill him. Because that's what I'm thinking about the Master. No matter how smart you think you are, he is always
brains
the smarter person. He always got a plan. He's always the smart person in the room. And I knew for a fact, there was no point when he was with the low Cyberman, because he knew exactly what it was. But the humans go in there, obviously the Cybermen land, and the Master kills the Lone Cyberman, but we find out that the Lone Cyberman's got his thing in his chest, which would kill all
the
organic
death particle.
That's not the death particle. Obviously the Master kills the Cyberman, takes
the death particle, and that gets embedded into him.
No, it's not the death particle, it's the Cyberian.
The Siberian particle that gets embedded into him. Anyway,
one of my favourite parts of this episode, when the Doctor used her memories, right, and we heard the Doctor Who theme song.
Yeah, I liked that.
That was really...
Music
to our ears.
I saw someone on Twitter say, oh, the Doctor defeat the Matrix with the theme tune.
Listen, that's the best thing when you're like, woo, dun-dun-dun-dun. It was... That episode was, oh yeah, that part was just, I freaking loved that. We saw clips of everything. We saw John Hurt as well. You know what, as well? I loved, you know what? I always love seeing media that acknowledges John Hurt's Doctor, because I feel like, not only because, you know, the late great John Hurt is not with us anymore, but also because, like, he was the Doctor when being the Doctor was impossible. Yeah. He was, and that's just, you know, RIP John, RIP man. He was a member today. And it went.
Hats to you, John.
Oh yeah, hats off to you. And then it went all the way back, and they chucked in the brain of Morbius there.
Yeah.
And
it's so like, does that mean that they were the Doctor?
Do you know why? It could be the Doctor, or it could be Morbius' body. But here's the thing: if there's one person who might know about this stuff, it would have been Morbius, because he was one of those, you know. Brain of Morbius, by the way, first time we see the Sister with a Card, amazing episode. If you like Hammer Horror, please check it out. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's an amazing episode.
Very Hammer Horror esque. But anyway, so then
Frankenstein.
That's it. It's very
Frankenstein. Probably what you could have based the Haunting Villa Diodati on.
It's very much like that. But yeah, so then we see, obviously, when the Doctor gets out of the Matrix, that amazing, beautiful moment. We see all the Doctor just, it was amazing.
I cheered.
It was good. It was brilliant. And we find out that the Master used the Siberium on, like, dead Time Lord bodies to create
Cyber Time Lords.
What
do they call them again? Cyber Masters or something like that.
Cyber Masters, something like that.
I think so. I can't remember.
Their design was really
cyber
cool.
I thought they looked kind of cool.
And they had, like, Cyber Time Lords, wasn't it?
We'll call them the Cyber Masters, or Cyber Time Lords, Cyber Lords, we'll just call them. What we did, the fact that they liked the grating of their thing that the Master turned down the crest, we saw so many amazing visuals of, like, old Time Lords, you know, all that stuff, society and all that. And also what we found out is that
there's references to their past as well, when they used to go around and be in the cloisters together, and, you know, whether that's a reference to the Doctor's past.
It could be, because there's a part in the Matrix when you see that woman talking to the Doctor, like, about, you know, what did that woman call herself? The Division or something. Yeah, the Division. Yeah. And so that, I think, is going to be the arc in the next series, because the Master mentioned about some of the data after that, the data's been deleted.
Deleted,
I reckon we're going to find out a bit more about that in the next series. So what's good is that in the next series we're going to find out more, I think, about the roof, about the future Doctor. Or just you know what? She is, you know, Ruth is the Doctor. So what's the actress who plays
Joe Martin?
That's it. She is the Doctor. She's the Doctor. You know, people call her Ruth for future to differentiate. She is the Doctor. Yeah. So we'll find out where she fits in the next series, and I think we'll also find out a bit more about the Division. I feel like that's gonna be the next. So see, there was answers. Yeah, and a bit more about them, like, investigating stuff. But anyway, so then near the end of the episode, the Doctor was going to use the death particle to kill all the Cyber Time Lords and all that. And
where if the Master would actually survive?
Yeah, and there was this one.
Ian McKinney's character again, where he finally uses the device to blow him up.
Oh yeah, because he was a Kostromos, wasn't he?
Kostromos,
one of the shining lights.
I liked him.
Very much like the old sage, a bit like Gandalf out of all of the
Rings. Yes, he was very, very wizard. Yes.
But he wasn't a wizard though.
Yeah, stop!
He didn't do anything with it.
hey, Cyberman!
Oh!
Whack someone in the head, like, oh!
He was my Cyberman. He fighter, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was a wizard.
Destroyed
up. He had a good old soldier vibe battle, but what was amazing, that part when, you know what it reminded me of? The part of John Sim and David Tennant was like, you never would, you coward. When Sasha the Master's he's like, come on, do it! Do it! And he's just like, he's going manic, he's like, just for one moment I thought he was gonna do it. And I think for one moment she almost did. And then obviously Coach Thomas came out and did the heroic deed and
he felt it was his duty to do it.
Yeah. And then obviously about Yaz, Graham and Ryan, they'd already gone back in their in the TARDIS, which is house.
Yeah.
I like that though because it fits the community style, because it just, it fits in perfectly there. The Doctor escapes a different TARDIS, which got stuff in the tree. She just got so left it there. Mm-hmm. And we're, you know, led to believe that, you know, well, all the Cybermen, all the, and then what's left of the Time Lords, they're all dead. The Master, don't forget the Master's TARDIS is still somewhere. Mm-hmm. So, to be honest, the Master's TARDIS could have been anything in that room.
Yeah.
So, he's the Master.
Yeah.
It's given, you know, it's given that he would find a way to escape.
Fights fire with fire, basically.
Yeah, exactly. And then obviously the Doctor escapes. In her own TARDIS, but out of nowhere, but Doom show up.
I wasn't expecting that. That I had no idea. No. I was not expecting that.
Ryan O'Brien show up.
Yep.
And cut her off.
And lock her off in a prison.
Because it's the same person.
They just didn't get that.
Exactly.
So the series ends obviously sort of with her in prison,
which is either the Shadow Proclamation or is it Sharda?
Sharda was a prison planet, wasn't it?
Vagnok is it? Vagnok or Sharda? Because in Sharda, in the episode that they completed the animation, but Sharda is a prison, isn't it?
Sharda was a prison planet.
Yeah.
That Quaragnon was
the guy who wore white.
Quaragnon was the shall we say the alien criminal.
Yeah.
That tried to take on the Doctor with these beings in Oxford.
And that's why Tom Baker dealt with him. But yeah, so then, we've got the name of the next episode, which is Revolution of the Daleks. And it adds to my, that's my favourite kind of Dalek title, when it's the something of the Daleks. Yeah. Like we've had, you know, you got Evil of the Daleks, Genesis of the Daleks, Day of the Daleks,
Revelation of the Daleks,
Revelation, the list goes on. Asylum of the Daleks.
Remembrance of the Daleks.
Evolution of the Daleks. And now we've got
Uprising of the Daleks.
It's going to be good. We sound like a Dalek Civil War, don't we?
That's a room writer. So apparently when they were filmed, because there were set photos and apparently videos of them filming filming with the Daleks. And apparently people who saw the film, apparently they mentioned that the Daleks were talking about impurity and one impure batch.
Harking back to remnants of the Daleks because again that whole
thing wasn't it evil.
Remnants of the Daleks. That's when they had the civil war, remember, between the Imperial Daleks
and the Renegade faction.
That's right.
Remember,
the Daleks' whole thing is about being pure and the whole Nazi sort of ideology and all that stuff. It makes sense when they go against the war against each other. So, favourite, I want you to give me, you guys, top three favourite moments from the episode. How are you giving me your top three favourite moments? One at a time, though. How you go first, then you, then me.
Okay then. Number one would probably be. Well, we all know definitely the bits where it shows you a lot of the Time Lord society and the backstory, everything like that. Secondly, the bit where the Master shrinks the Cybermen down to size.
That's very good.
And the third bit would probably be the bit in it where.
What's his name? Who are you thinking about?
The old guy.
Koshamas.
Koshamas finally. Squares up to the Master and says, like, look, you want to phase, get my friends?
Yeah.
And then he just like checkmates him.
Go on.
Does it.
The Doctor facing off against the Matrix of the Matrix with the Doctor Who theme tune. The stuff about the other Doctors and everything. Yeah. And, I can't think of a third one.
I've seen at the end where we're talking about.
I can't think of the third one. Those are the two that stick out in my mind.
I'm going to give an honorable mention as well after this, but my three are.
Yeah, it was only Captain Jack this episode, which I.
And he was technically in it!
I'm not counting. That should not count. I was peak of Power Radio, but it's just a footage from other episodes.
So my three are that scene where when the Master's trying to get the Doctor to do it, it's so manic. The Doctor Who theme song bit, that was just amazing. Just seeing all the parts of all the old school parts of Gallifrey, and learning about how you know Gallifrey as we know it started. Honourable mention goes to that scene with Graham and Yaz.
That's a very sweet,
very tender.
Just a sweet moment where Graham just tells Yaz, "You're an incredible person," and I feel myself. The companions did amazing in this episode. And you know what? I think the Cyber Warriors looked amazing. I cannot wait for
Revolution. Whether it's a Christmas special or a
Christmas special.
Was that the fifth Dalek or something? Oh, so they've got Resurrection of the Daleks, Remembrance of the Daleks, Revelations of the Daleks,
and Resolution, which really should be called Resolution of the Daleks.
But yeah, so guys, what do you give it out of 10?
I would give it personally an 8 to a 9.5 out of 10.
I don't know yet. I'm still trying to process it. I know that I liked it.
Yeah.
I just think it was
historic for me.
I'm like there was a lot going on, and I'm like, I'm not entirely sure where I would break
such
it. I don't know if it's my favorite episode of the series yet.
The haunting of
the Adati is fantastic.
Yeah, I hope
Maxine Alton comes back and writes it.
I'll give it a 10. I think all the elements, the Master, Cybermen, Cyborgs. Sasha the One. It's been. So you know what? Advertising for Sasha.
Completely insane.
Yeah. Oh, he's a very beautiful man. Yeah. And Sasha the One. You know what? We didn't know when the full series came out. We had no idea. We had rumors that it was going to be there. But you know what? Sasha the One is, I think, my favorite, most surprising. I mean, there have been lots of surprising things about this series. He's definitely.
You have had historically wise.
Oh yeah.
You have had basically Noor Nat Khan, Ada Lovelace, Mary Shelley, Percy Shelley, all the whole lot of Doctor Nikola Tesla. Even have had. Such amazing people.
This series, so many surprises. The Master coming back, Jack coming back.
Yeah.
Joe Martin as the Doctor. And the whole thing about the Timeless Children and the Malone Cyberman. I think this series has been amazing. And you know what else?
It's been a good one. Nothing
about this series I could have predicted. Nothing. We had no idea.
Yeah.
And that's why, you know what? That's the best thing as a Doctor Who fan. Being surprised, being excited, like, shout out to the BBC for keeping this under wraps. Thank you so much. Like, it's being excited and being surprised. Like, this, it's been a great time to be a Doctor Who fan. I'm gonna miss Doctor Who now this is always, but as Doctor Who fans, this is the hard part.
Yeah.
Knowing that we
just the waiting and formulating the plans
Christmas or New Year, so.
Inside your head and just waiting for that moment
for Doctor Who
to come back. But it will come back, it'll be better than ever, and it will probably...
Hopefully Series 13 could be
game-changing again, yes.
You know what, and also, can we just give a massive shout-out to Jodie Whittaker?
She was fantastic in this.
She was really good in this episode.
Yeah, she sure is.
I absolutely love her. Yeah. I think she's an incredible Doctor.
I really like her as a Doctor.
And you know what? In this episode as well, I think this episode has brought so much mystery, because now everything we thought we knew was a lie. Oh my God!
The Master's telling the truth.
Yeah. And the whole time! Oh, the Master! Good.
That's
good,
why I was like, can't you just stop rubbing it in, for God's
sake? Give us a series of torture in between, please! Believe me, people are hungry for Jack!
Bring back Ace or whatever.
But anyway, guys, we're going to wrap it up now. I just want to say, guys, what did you think of today's episode of Doctor Who? Do you agree with us? Do you have your own opinions? Mm. I'm sure you do. I want to hear it in the comments section down below. Guys, I'll see you guys. Say your goodbyes and I'll do mine.
Goodbye, everybody, and I hope you guys stay.
To Geronimo.
Alonzi, guys, stay beautiful, stay wonderful, stay you, and I will say this. And I'll say, today's to come, all my love to long ago. Peace out, guys.
Peace out, guys.
My thoughts on this week's episode of Doctor Who is exactly the same as my thoughts of the Doctor Who, this series in general, and I think it's been absolutely fantastic. There have been some defining episodes. There have been where the Doctor and Doctor itself will be basically going on a new journey and rewrites Doctor Who. It rewrites much of the things we thought about the Doctor, and it gives us more questions asked now. And I mean, it has been one of those series this year where we've gone, wow, that's different. This is bold. This is different. I mean, when we had where Jack returned, no one expected that. This is what this series has been about. I mean, when we, the first episode of Doctor Who, this series, when we saw the Master return, these things normally take time and basically run to the actual season finale, but no, it's been a gradual process. We have had to go through this journey to get to this point, but it has been one of those journeys that we've absolutely been absolutely fantastic, and I've really, really enjoyed it. I'm looking forward to the Christmas or New Year's Day special. I think it's going to be, I hope it's going to be fantastic. But yeah, this series overall, I would say, where is it? 8 out of 10 episodes were fantastic. 2 of the episodes, Praxis and All 55, were okay episodes. Were not my favourites, but I mean, they weren't terrible episodes, I guess. Okay episodes, but overall I think it's been an absolutely fantastic series. The Timeless Children was fantastic. I would give it a 10 out of 10. I think it's been a defining moment for Doctor Who, a defining moment that's going to change Doctor Who forever. And I believe that Chris Kimnall has done some fantastic things this series. Which I'm looking forward to for the next journey the Doctor's going to go through into the next series. So I'm really excited for it.